And a welcome to you inside Carver Arena here in downtown Peoria. It's Bradley basketball right here on the Valley on ESPN. And tonight it's the NBC meets the OVC as the Braves welcome in the SIUE Cougars. As we bring you into the broadcast now, and happy holidays to you and yours. Back in the saddle with my guy, Matt McClain. I am Brian Beto. And Matt, non-conference slate, it's dwindling down, and yet another night where the Braves welcome in a team that expects to compete for their league's title.
Yeah, without a doubt. Southern Illinois, Edwardsville comes into Carver Arena, picks second preseason in the OVC. Both teams in a little bit of a funk right now. Big, big opportunity for both as the non-conference season wraps up tonight.
Well, the Cougars, a very experienced group. They return a lot of their scoring, a lot of their minutes. But we'll highlight Shamar Wright for you.
Yeah, without a doubt, Shamar Wright, a really electric player for the Cougars. Leads the program all time in minutes played. Leads the team as well this season in scoring 16 points per game. Really does everything for the Cougars on both sides of the basketball.
And for the Braves, we'll highlight a big in Darius Hanna.
Yeah, two really good big guys to look forward to tonight. Darius Hanna's been playing excellent this season, taking a big step forward on the offensive side of the basketball. And, you know, does a little bit of everything for the Braves. He's really got a good nose for the basketball. Rebounds and crashing the glass, Darius Hanna has been an X factor for the Braves this season. Another chance for him tonight to have a big game.
Let's take a quick look at the keys to the game tonight. What do both teams have to do to be successful?
Yeah, without a doubt, SIUE really good at crashing the boards. Big for them. Bradley has a negative rebounding margin so far this season, and their bench production had 56 points off the bench in their last victory, but they usually only play five or six guys, so if they can get some bench production tonight, really big key for them. For Bradley, it's valuing the basketball, valuing that rock, and coming off a game where they had their most turnovers in a single game this season, 19, really want to take care of the basketball. And then pushing the tempo. SIUE likes to play really, really slow. Bradley, if they can get out in transition, get some easy buckets, will be a big key to the basketball game tonight.
All right, Matt, what do you say we get going here on a Thursday night here in Central Illinois? Starting lineups have been announced. You get a look at the Bradley huddle. We'll first quickly give you the starters for the Cougars. DeMarco Minor, Rayshawn Taylor, Terrence Thompson, the junior, and then the aforementioned Shamar Wright and his twin brother, Lamar Wright, will round it out for the Cougars. Bradley, due to some adjustments, injuries, Connor Hickman again out tonight. They'll run out this lineup. Starting tonight, we're going to have Amari and Ellis getting the start once again. Christian Davis, who nearly played the hero in Monday night's game, Malibu Lions. Duke Dean coming off a 15-point performance. And Darius Hanna, who you just heard Matt chat about, will round it out for the Braves. Bradley comes in at 6-5 overall, 3-2 here at home. SIUE 7-5 overall, but they are winless on the road at 0-5 as Matt referenced, picked second in the preseason poll in the Ohio Valley. A team that was in the mix for the majority of the season last year, expects to be again this year. And both teams trying to get right heading into conference play for SIUE. That will be next Friday in OVC action against Eastern Illinois. Bradley leads the all-time series 5-0. The sixth ever matchup between these two programs is now underway as the Braves control the tip.
Yeah, and Brian, as you kind of mentioned, both teams have been battle-tested early in this season. SIUE looking for their first true road win of the season. You see Darius Hanna throwing it down for the opening points of the game.
So the Braves execute on a design play to start the ball game. They get an uncontested dunk from Hanna. He already fulfills his quota on the first play of the game. See if he can exceed that the rest of the way. Here is Minor, the 6-foot junior out of Chicago. You're going to hear a lot about the Wright brothers, a lot about Rayshawn Taylor, but you really should also hear a lot about DeMarco Minor.
Yeah, without a doubt, you see Wright flash into the hoop, and Malibu Lions, the weak side, comes and blocks that one away. He's going to stay with the Cougars, just three to shoot, Brian. But as you were kind of mentioning with Minor, a guy who really, really has a great nose for the basketball, leads the team in rebounding at just 6 foot flat, 9 rebounds a game, really impressive player for the Cougars.
For Lions, his 12th block of the year, that matches Hanna for team high honors. Offensive rebound and a quick stick back by Thompson, averaging just under 6 points per game, and he gets the Cougars on the board.
Yeah, and Terrence Thompson, one of those players that Coach Brony says has a really high IQ, really good motor. You see him crashing the glass there for the easy putback, getting SIUE on the board here early on.
Dean, who really stuffed the stat sheet on Monday in the game against Duquesne. Floats one up, left it a little bit short, and Thompson the rebound.
Yeah, looked like he may have had coming off a quick pick and roll. Darius Hanna going for the lob for the potential alley-oop. Instead, Dean goes with the floater, unable to get to go.
Step back jumper from Miner is followed by Wright. Shamar Wright lost it on his way up, and Ellis comes away with it. Here's Dean up the floor. In transition, Ellis thought about a three, had it poked away by Shamar Wright into the arms of Rayshon Taylor.
Yeah, and turnovers have been one of the things that Bradley has really wanted to try to work on this week. As you see, Rayshon Taylor knocked down the deep triple.
A 40% three-point shooter knocks down a tough one, and Davis answers on the other end.
Yeah, just what the Braves needed. Christian Davis wide open in the corner, knocks that one down to get this ball game knotted back up at 5-all.
Davis' last three-point attempt momentarily tied the game against Duquesne in the closing minute.
And Davis, really a three-point specialist, shooting 40% from behind the arc this season. Second best percentage for the Braves on the squad this year. Somebody's really taking a step forward. Nice move there, going to the bucket. Miner, nice spin move. Able to draw the contact. Gonna get to the line here for two.
We talked about his rebounding prowess, or you did. This is also an area that he really excels in. He actually led the Ohio Valley with an 87.6 free throw percentage last year. He made 47 in a row at one point a year ago, which is, as you might suspect, an OVC record.
Yeah, absolutely. Adding on to that, one of those games within that stretch, he went 15 of 15 against Southern Indiana. So a guy just prolific, getting to the line and converting once he does get there.
Cougars as a team came in 70% from the stripe. And he makes good on a pair.
And you're going to see SIUE mix it up a lot with their defenses as well. They run a 1-2-2 zone, kind of three-quarter court pressure, and then they kind of tend to drop back into a man-to-man and see what they pick up here.
Jump pass from Davis. Can't get it on this corner after he knocked one down in the opposite corner last possession. In transition, up top, Taylor from deep, and that one in and out. And Hannah the rebound.
Yeah, early, but a little bit of a heat check for Rayshon Taylor. Is feeling himself after that first one. Gonna get that one to rattle home.
They give to Davis. This time drives in and fades from the mid-range. And Thompson the rebound, and here come the Cougars the other way. Miner being worked on by Malavai Leons. Matt mentioned it, but SIUE doesn't play with a ton of pace. They're actually towards the bottom of Division I when it comes to just tempo and pace of play. Step back jumper is good by Miner. He's got four for the Cougars.
Yeah, talking about that pace of play, they average, their average offensive possession is 19 seconds. That is definitely near the bottom in terms of Division I basketball. I see nice shot fake by Malvi Leons, and gonna get a foul here on Lamar Wright, flashing out to the ball. Gonna stay with Bradley here with 21 to shoot.
Demarion Birch and Amit Yonovic will come in for the Braves. Still 21 on the shot clock. That's the first team foul on the Cougars. I mentioned Bradley 5-0 all time against SIUE. It was a tightly contested one. Ooh. Last year in Edwardsville. The SIUE had an 8-point lead at halftime. Bradley came back and was able to hold on for a 2-point win.
And hold on by about 1/10 of a second.
Because
exactly. SIUE threw one in on a remarkable play. But I know that Coach Baroni and his guys remember that. There are a lot of returners in this team. They're motivated to try to get a little bit of revenge from last season, without a doubt.
Yonovic with 2 seconds remaining and possessing it first before the shot clock went off was Wright. In transition, right to right, he lays it in.
Yeah, beautiful pass as well. And it's gonna be Shamar Wright laying that one in on the 3-on-1 fast break. Cougars doing a really good job of getting out in transition.
Here's Leons. Miscommunication, but Davis tracks it down in the corner with Dean with 12 to shoot. Opposite corner, good ball movement, finds Davis for three.
Yeah, that's passing up a good shot and getting a great one. Get into the high percentage three-point shooter. It's Davis knocking down his second triple. Much needed bucket for the Braves, pulling him within a three now.
Yeah, six early points for Davis, and that stops a 6-0 run from the Cougars.
I'm really impressed with SIUE's offense here early on. We mentioned their prowess attacking the offensive glass. Got a couple of opportunities there. Miner unable to pull up and make that one. Braves look to get out in transition as well.
Dean steps back and connects.
Yeah, Yarvin did a great job there too as well, sealing off his man right there in the paint. Really created a lot of space for Dean, who's able to beat his defender one-on-one. Knock down the mid-range jumper for his first field goal.
Miner goes opposite the screen and he'll shoot two more. After the foul on the way in, who was that, Christian Davis? It's going to be on Yonovic.
Pick up Yonovic.
And Miner will shoot two when we come back. 14:35 remaining here in the half. Off to a good start here. 11-10 is the score. You're watching the Valley on ESPN.
And Doug.
Customize and save with Liberty Bibberty. Liberty Bushima. Liberty Blibbity.
Mark that one. That was nice.
I think you're supposed to stand over there.
Oh, am I? Thank you.
So a couple more, but we'll go quick.
Libru smibu. Libru bribu. Limu bibu. And me.
He's an emu!
Only pay for what you need.
Popeye's new chicken wings make no sense. Marinated in Louisiana spices, hand-battered and flipped, and then we have the audacity to call all five flavors fast food? Someone should really say something, or order something.
With all these Hilton Honors points, I could stay for free.
Mm-hmm. At the Waldorf Astoria in the Maldives.
What about the canopy in Paris?
Mm-hmm. Hilton Honors, babe.
When you want points that can take you anywhere, it matters where you stay. Hilton, for the stay. ESPN.
Eleven to ten is the score here in Peoria. You get a look at the Cougars huddle out to a one-point lead, and in the midst there is Brian Baroni in his fifth season as the head man for the Cougars. Assisted the two previous years before being named the head coach. You see the 19-14 record last year. That was the program's first winning season since being moved into a Division I program, and he really has this team and this program going in the right direction. We'll talk more on that. Of course, the connection with Brian Baroni and Brian Wardle, they coached together at Green Bay for several years. There's a lot of connection with Brian Baroni and the Wright brothers, which we'll get into as well. And then the Valley connection with his dad, Tony Baroni, coaching at Creighton as well.
And being assistant at Bradley. And we can't forget as well, Brian Baroni and Brian Wardle played together at Marquette under
absolutely.
Tom Crean. So there's a lot of connections. It was nice to see them pregame. You see the coaches wearing ugly Christmas sweaters. I don't know if I'd call them ugly, but
they're actually
fire. Nice. Some fire. They embraced before the game, and two lifelong friends, without a doubt. They know each other really well. Really great for these two programs to be able to play each other the last 3 years. The end of this kind of three-game series that they have right now, but nonetheless, good to have them here tonight, SIUE.
Stop the presses. DeMarco Miner missed a free throw. And it's a two-point lead for SIUE. Meta had it nearly taken away. Draws the double, trying to muscle it away from Wright.
A great hustle, Shamar Wright.
Yeah.
Yeah, great job. Great hands right there. Knocked the ball loose. First one on the floor. That just all passion and desire right there. Earned his team another possession.
So here's Miner, who began his career at South Suburban College. Led that team to a perfect record. And Junior College Division II National Championship. Here's Taylor with a little bit of space.
Ooh.
And high arcing shot over the outstretched arms of Leons gets the bucket.
Yeah, Leons is trailing the play and his outstretched arm comes across. What a job by Taylor to readjust. There's like a pump fake in midair to kind of work on that release. Beautiful finish by Rayshon Taylor.
Birch on the pick and roll to Yonovic, and he'll shoot two.
Yeah, Shamar Wright a little late to get over on the help side defense there. That's just a simple 1-2 pick and roll. Getting to the big man, going to the bucket. And Meta's going to have a chance for two here.
So Yonovic will go to the stripe. 7 of 11 at the free throw line this year, the sophomore. gets the first.
Has a really nice touch as well
from
the free throw line. Just kind of, you know, he came in last year. Bradley had a scholarship open up. He came in midseason, kind of had to learn the game of basketball a little bit, but he's got a great touch, really nice footwork, runs the floor well, a really skilled big man for the Braves, a great pickup midseason last year.
And certainly someone you can see the marketable improvement game after game as Leons gives the Braves another opportunity, but Ellis throws it into the arm of Desmond Polk, who just checked in. Good defense by Leons. Now with it. Arnis Sakanis into the ball game as well. Step back three is off right, and Jonovic clears it for the Braves.
Yeah, nice sail by Jonovic, and Leons did a good job of defending that one-on-one move from Miner. Really tough fall away three. See if Bradley can take advantage of it here.
Leons gives to Jonovic, who was too strong with it. Good box out by Wright.
Now they got numbers, 5-on-4. They're quick.
Ethan Yancey, who just came in as well, nearly turns it over. In fact, he does. And now the Braves have numbers the other way. Dean gets a step, steps back, and hits the heel of the rim. Leons fights to keep it alive, and he gets his first two of the night.
Always so active, Malvi Leons. Dude, great job right there, crashing the glass. And nice patience as well with the shot fake, able to kiss that one off the glass and lay it in.
Already with three boards for Leons, his first bucket. Braves back within one. Yancey triggers a three left side, and that's good.
Yeah, really sweet stroke there for Ethan Yancey, knocking it down from the wing. Nice shot.
Second triple of the night for the Cougars on four attempts. Back to a four-point lead. Dean sidesteps a three, and he answers at the other end. That's the second time tonight. So both threes that SIUE has hit, the Braves have answered immediately on the other end.
Yeah, without a doubt. I love to see that aggressiveness from Dean as well, able to get a couple of steps of separation. You know, he's a volume three-point shooter, highest volume three-point shooter. He's shot 67 three-pointers this year. Really kind of struggled, though, coming in at a clip of 28% this season. But just the guy who always has the green light. Coach Wardle always wants him to shoot that, and he knocks it down there.
Yeah, coming off a 15-point game as Sakanis can't finish at the rim.
Yeah, it's a tough one. Got to have that one. A bunny right there, and Coach Baroni knows it.
And they're going to get Leons for a travel. Right at the top of the circle, and it'll go back to the Cougars out of the timeout with a...
Now that the holidays are over, I'm getting a Camry.
and we're getting a RAV4 hybrid.
And I'm getting a Tundra.
Oh, and you're getting a belly rub.
And I'm getting a truck.
Right now, during Toyota-thon, you can get $2,000 cash back on a new Tundra hybrid when you finance through Toyota Financial Services.
Come in today, but you're already here.
Toyota, let's go places.
Hurry in, America. It's time to visit your Ford dealer for the final days of the Make the Holidays Bright sales event. Choose from a large inventory of Ford vehicles equipped with technology and flexibility for any season. It's your last chance to get special offers on our great selection of Ford vehicles. Only during the final days of the Make the Holidays Bright sales event. Choose FlexBuy on a new Ford F-150 and get 2.9% APR financing for 66 months plus $2,500 FlexBuy cash only at your local Ford dealer.
17-16 is the score, and yes, believe it or not, that is the Bradley coach and staff and Brian Wardle there as well in his ninth season, the Valley's Coach of the Year last year. Four seasons of 20-plus wins, looking for his 138th win. He's just two wins away in Valley play from matching Jim Less, already in the top five for Bradley coaches in the top five in program history in Missouri Valley Conference wins. But I mean, we can't not talk about the sweaters.
Oh, I mean, the sweaters are just immaculate.
I love the idea. You know me, I love this type of stuff. And just trying to keep it light around the holidays, as typically you see the formal suits and wears and whatnot. But I love assistant coach Mike Black as well. He's got the Fresh Prince, Will Smith.
Yeah.
One with the big cell phones on the back.
That's pretty tough to beat. That's tough to beat, without a doubt. A lot of fire.
And Wardle with the Air Santa. sweater on as well. Right wing three is no good. And kudos to Brian Baroni as well for playing along. He's got one on as well for the Cougars.
Yeah, is that an audible? Is that, I mean, he think on his feet? I mean, he's got the abominable snowman. Like, he's got the Yeti thing going on.
Maybe he just packed it for the road, right?
It's his travel.
Just happened to have.
Exactly. Yeah, you got to have some fun, without a doubt, especially the holiday season.
Yeah, absolutely.
Good to see these guys keeping it light. And you see SIUE here coming out. Looks like a little bit of a matchup, maybe 1-2-2 zone.
How about Cade Hartke into the ball game as well as Ellis comes up short on the three. So Hartke getting in as well. Let's see if he can provide a good lift with a couple minutes here off the bench. And Dean tracks down the rebound. He had three the other night. In the corner, there's Davis, who already has two triples. At the midway point now of the first half, guarded by Taylor is Dean.
Excellent man-to-man defense there by Taylor, keeping Dean in front of him. Now just 9 seconds to operate for the Braves.
Here's Hannah looking back door for a cutting Ellis, who slipped. And it looks like SIUE, Yancey was on the baseline when he made contact with the basketball. So it will stay with Bradley, just four on the shot clock.
Yeah.
Get another look.
I always like to remind our viewers as well, we are at Carver Arena. There's ice under us because it's a hockey arena as well. We know very well because it's cold under our feet. And we like to cry about it and complain. But it does also
double
make the
socks.
Floor. Got to do the double socks. It does also make the playing surface, the court, slippery from time to time right there. So good job staying with the play. Bradley got to get a shot up here.
Now two, and Dean will launch. He got it off, and no, they're going to wave it off.
Didn't count.
And they're going to take a look at it. It was real close.
Yeah, happened right here in front of us. Couldn't tell if he got it off in time or not. It was to the naked eye, really tough to tell. See, our official's going to get another look at it. It's going to be a great view here. Look out for the zero. It looks like still in his hand. But yeah, that's one of those situations, 4 seconds on the shot clock, baseline out of bounds play. You gotta know the situation, gotta know your role right there. Bradley gotta do a better job getting that shot off in time. It's gonna be a turnover, say the shot clock violation.
Yeah, so it's not gonna count. They got it right on the floor. So it'll be Cougar basketball.
Yeah, definitely the right call. You're getting another look right here. Clock hits zero, ball still in the hands of Dean. Great job in our truck, guys, getting this one for us. You see right there. Excellent view.
So it'll be Taylor to bring it up, averaging just under 13 points per game. One of four Cougars averaging double figures. Lamar Wright will set the ball screen. Went for a pick and pop. Right corner three from Yancey.
They got hit,
nothing.
Too.
Tried to draw. Foul, yeah.
Excuse me, Brian. Looked like there was a little bit of contact there. And they say play through it. Maybe one of those situations like I'm trying to draw the foul on a bad shot.
SIUE has been leading most of the way. Bradley trying to change that on this trip. No look to Leons on the ball fake. Spins middle, back up top. Dean's been hot and stays that way with a three.
Yeah, no denying that one's going to count. Duke Dean gets that three ball to go. Gives the Braves the lead.
He's got eight, which leads all scorers.
Oh.
And a tip back slam is good by Terrence Thompson to tie it up at 19. Dean the other way, weaving through traffic and pulls it out.
Thompson timed that perfectly off of the weak side, right off the glass. Throws it down with two. Emphatic finish.
Davis gets the screen from Hannah, and the defender didn't see it coming. Short baseline. Deuce bounces out, and a whistle and a foul is going to go on Christian Davis.
Man, that's two grown men going through that contact right there. Excellent screen. Darius Hannah fighting through the contact as well. SIUE catches a break. Hannah missed the baseline jumper.
And I beg your pardon, that's on Leon, so that's his second. So he'll head to the bench. Leon's 2 points, four rebounds, and an assist. And Birch will come in for him, the freshman from Milwaukee, as Miner will bring it up for the Cougars.
Yeah, and how about this lineup? We got a couple newcomers out there, a walk-on. Christian Davis is the elder statesman out there right now for the Braves. Definitely a lineup that hasn't played much together, not much chemistry on the court. But you see right there, going to get a moving screen going against SIUE and coming back Bradley Ball.
Again, no Connor Hickman for the Braves. The Braves continue to search for the right combinations here as non-conference play dwindles down and they get back to resuming Valley play just on the other side of the new year. Birch is open for a three. That's good.
That is just textbook offensive ball movement against a zone. Get the ball in the high post. Look opposite. Birch wide open for the three and gets it to go. See SIUE trying to get a quick answer on the other end, draw the contact. And after this break, going to go to the line for two.
Yeah, 22-19 the score. You said it, Matt. The threat of Elmar Atlas in from deep, I think, created that wide-open shot for Birch, and he has Bradley on top. It'll be two free throws coming up after this for the Cougars on the Valley on ESPN.
People want to define Gen Z, but that's our job.
I wait tables, but last week, I built a field hospital.
I put out a forest fire.
I stopped 1,000 attackers.
And a natural disaster.
I've saved lives.
And led a team on patrol.
I serve.
While I go to school full-time.
While I work full-time.
The greater the challenge, the stronger we become.
That would just be a fair way, yeah.
$5 duo at Burger King. Double up flavors when hunger dings. Whopper Jr. and Royal Crispy Wraps for a lunch, dinner, or late night snack.
BK. Have it your way.
So robotic, curly, fry up in my chest, got soft skin, hard feelings, give a damn, then give a reason, pop it, top feeling, been a feeling, been a feeling, baby, baby, baby. Alright, okay, I did it my way.
With all these Hilton Honors points, I could stay for free.
Mm-hmm. At the Waldorf Astoria in the Maldives?
What about the Canopy in Paris?
Mm-hmm. Hilton Honors, babe.
When you want points that can take you anywhere, it matters where you stay. Hilton, for the stay.
Brian Beto, Matt McClain back with you, and a trip to Arch Madness in St. Louis isn't complete without visiting the MVC Fan Hangout. Arch Madness tips off March 7th through 10th, and the MVC Fan Hangout at Ballpark Village is the best place to celebrate before and after games, featuring restaurants, entertainment, and all things Arch Madness. For more information, visit archmadness.com and click on Fan Hangout. Bradley with a three-point lead, which is their largest so far of the night. But a chance to eat right back into that for DeMarco Miner, who's got 5 points, including 3 of 4 from the stripe. First one is good. Bradley very efficient, 8 of 15 from the floor, including 5 of 7 from three. Braves came in and the top third in the country in effective field goal percentage and measuring their efficiency, and they've been that here tonight so far.
And you see Bradley taking their time against that 1-2-2 zone, and now the Cougars fall back into their man-to-man defense. And just 10 seconds to operate for Bradley, really making this a short possession thanks to that full court pressure. A nice steal by Mehta. Unable to get that bounce pass. Gonna have to put this one up.
Dean does instead. And he's just on fire here in the first half with 11. His third triple in as many attempts. And the Braves back to a 4-point lead.
Yeah, Duke Dean right now putting the Braves offense on his back. And just unconscious from behind the arc here early on. And he even made a 35 footer, didn't count.
I was gonna say the only thing that stopped him is the shot clock
exactly.
Going off so far. Miner gets the ball screen. Now 5 to shoot up top. Good closeout by Atlason. Shamar Wright has to launch and didn't touch anything, and it's a shot clock violation. Now one by each side here in the first half. And you could feel the momentum creeping towards Bradley a little bit with under seven to play here in the first half.
Yeah, and a lot of that begins with defensive stops. So you get the shot clock right there, and a really good turnover there to Bradley's defense. Great job during that 30-second possession. And now see if the offense can take advantage of AC Davis. Wide open three, unable to get the go.
Yeah, good luck. And Bradley on the other end, like you mentioned, they're holding SIUE to just 35% from the floor. That number will rise after the mid-range jumper. Over a 7-1 Jonovic on top of it.
Yeah, nice job by Miner getting that over Jonovic, who was there to close it out and just seals off the defender. Two defenders on his back there, Meta, as Duke Dean swoops in and lays that one up and in.
Uncontested, as high percentage of a look as Duke Dean is going to get. Talked about his great game on Monday with 15. He's just too shy of that already here in the first half tonight. Taylor has one spin off.
Rebound. Yeah, that was a gang rebound right there between Burge and Dean. He says, here, give me that. I'm feeling myself. Let's see a transition three.
Had that one blocked, and Miner read the heat check there by Dean, but it was blocked, I was going to say. So it will remain Bradley basketball. Still plenty of time on the shot clock, and Hannah will come in for Jonovic.
Now, you had mentioned earlier in the broadcast, Brian, the great overall game that Duke Dean had against Duquesne. Well, we mentioned the 15 points, also had four assists and three steals. It was kind of all over the place and getting it done on both sides of the floor for Bradley and, you know, being pretty much the only ball dominant guard on the team right now with Connor Hickman being injured.
Dean got himself caught in the air, but he saved the possession for the moment as he tossed it off Miner.
Gonna have 10 seconds to operate out of this baseline out of bounds in the corner here. See if Bradley can get something going towards the basket, maybe. Nope, Dean wide open.
And another three for Dean.
My goodness. Coach Maroney's gotta be saying, somebody get out there and guard that guy. It's just throwing it in, Duke Dean. 16 first half points.
On four triples, trying to answer is Taylor on the other end, and he does just that. All OVC first team last year, preseason all first team OVC this year.
And how about Taylor? I mean, Dean for another three.
And do you believe it? He's unconscious from three here in the first half.
Let's see if he can play some D against Miner as well. Nice closeout, beautiful shot by Miner, no good. And Duke Dean is feeling it right now, yelling at the Bradley bench.
He's open.
Yeah, he might have some Steph Curry freedom right now. Let's see if they can get him a ball screen, get downhill.
He steps back, he lets it go.
Oh.
Just short.
Yeah, big possession here for SIUE. Taylor does a nice job distributing. Met at the rim, look like Allison got some ball. And gonna go to the line here. It's gonna be Shamar Wright though, nonetheless. Got a little extracurriculars here as well.
Officials having words under the basket, and making sure Miner's okay. He's on the ground. I don't know if he's holding his hand or what the deal is.
Maybe his groin.
Looks like Arnis Sakanis is going to come back in.
And there's definitely some extracurricular going on there. Looks like he's going to be all right. Miner getting up right now. Training staff coming out to look at him, but you can feel the temperature. It's getting hotter here. You know, these guys are a high tempo game right now.
Ooh,
and
ice is having a lot of fun us.
Yeah, without a doubt.
Yeah, about the half from Duke game, Matt. I mean, 7 of 11 from the floor, 5 of 7 from three, 19 points already. And talked about the volume shooter, and you got to figure that those distance percentages were going to increase as the season's gone on, and a night so far like this is going to do that for you.
Oh yeah, without a doubt. I mean, last year Duke Dean absolutely prolific from behind the three-point arc for the Braves, and he transferred from Troy where he made like 68 threes in his true freshman year at Troy. And now the referees come together that they are going to look at this last play. After the foul, there was a little bit of extracurricular under the hoop, so they're going to take a look at that real quick and just make sure that there was nothing malicious.
So already a new season high for Dean. He got to 15 twice. We talked about the game against Duquesne. He also had 15 in the season opener against UAB. His career high is 26, which came, ironically, 367 days ago, a year ago in 2 days, against Stonehill here at Carver. And I don't know what they called, but whatever it is, it seems common because everyone's lined up at the foul line.
They were going to make sure they had the correct foul shooter. So they confirmed right, 42, yep, all good. So all good on that, common foul, and it's going to be Shamar Wright going to the line.
The Cougars' fifth all-time leading scorer. He's one of 18 players, including his teammate Rayshon Taylor, to score at least 1,000 points in his SIUE career. 74% foul shooter. Talked about the connection to Brian Barone, him and his twin brother Lamar have. Father is the late Lorenzen Wright, who had an outstanding career, both collegiately and the NBA. And Lorenzen played for Tony Barone of the Memphis Grizzlies.
Yeah, absolutely. I love the family connection, as you mentioned. There's another family connection with Rayshon Taylor and Brian Taylor being cousins on the team as well, too. So, you know, you talk about your team being your family. You want to have a family atmosphere, and your program is your family. But they really are a family on and off the court, no doubt.
Leon's back in with the two fouls.
Tough shot.
Defended well by Lamar Wright. Tracked down by Yancey, trying to wrestle it away from Ellis, and he does so. Here is Taylor, gets the ball screen from Sakanis. I don't know if that was a pass or a shot, it doesn't matter, it's Bradley basketball. But that will have to wait until we come back. 3:43 remaining here in the half. Bradley with a 5-point lead here on a Thursday night in Peoria.
Hurry in, America. It's time to visit your Ford dealer for the final days of the Make the Holidays Bright Sales event. Choose from a large inventory of Ford vehicles equipped with technology and flexibility for any season. It's your last chance to get special offers on our great selection of Ford vehicles. Only during the final days of the Make the Holidays Bright Sales event. Choose FlexBuy on a new Ford SUV and get 1.9% APR financing for 66 months, plus $3,500 FlexBuy cash, only at your local Ford dealer.
Located inside the Holiday Inn & Suites Peoria at Grand Prairie.
Bradley University student athletes live their sport, so when an injury occurs, they need a team of specialists focused and ready to get them back in action. The sports medicine doctors at OSF Healthcare, in partnership with Great Plains Orthopedics, are specially trained to restore function to injured athletes so they can get back to competing as soon as possible. OSF Healthcare and Great Plains Orthopedics are proud to be the official sports medicine providers for Bradley Athletics.
The score. Bradley with a 5-point lead. But Matt, it's been the Duke Dean Show here in the first half. Really picking up where he left off on Monday night and then some here in the first half tonight.
Folks, your TV screen is not lying to you. This is not a replay of the same three over and over and over again. It is Duke Dean absolutely unconscious from behind the three-point arc. That three didn't count. Might be the most impressive of all of them. 5-7 from behind the arc. A fadeaway three, a transition three. My goodness, Duke Dean really, really having an excellent first half here for Bradley.
We talked about the 26 that he had as a career best against Stonehill last year. He had 7 threes in that ball game as well, which, as you would suspect, is his career high for 3-point makes. Just two away here with 23 and change game minutes remaining. And Bradley with the basketball, Hartke back in.
And if you're SIUE, so you get manufacture a turnover here, and it looks like Duke Dean maybe tweaked an ankle. Keep an eye on that. Nonetheless, a free possession here for SIUE.
Yeah, he's putting a little bit of pressure on it, but slight limp, but he's able to just continue to walk that one off.
They got a mismatch here, too, to see if they can get right in the post. But great job by
Hartke. Look at the hustle by Hartke, chased down by Miner. Shot clock did not reset, so now it's at 9. Here's Miner going to try to go downhill, cut off by Lyons. And Lyons has got it on a spin cycle. Yancey goes in. I don't think he got it off, and he did not.
Yep, waved that one off as
They're
well.
They're going to look at it, though. And Birch's thought was going to come back in, but it'll stay out. But good hustle by Hartke, and you get another look.
I don't know. Really close right there. That angle's tough. You see the backboard right there, but Yancey.
I love the young fans behind
yeah,
saying,
they
nope,
think that's good?
I love it.
Hey, Yancey did a good job of getting all the way to the rim, but it's one of those you maybe just prefer a stop and pop mid-range jumper to get that shot off in time. It's going to be a close one.
Yeah, I love the. We get one more look.
This is going to be the best view. Look at the backboard here, and we'll look when the light goes off. They may not have enough evidence to overturn it. It might be one of those scenarios where they go with the call on the floor. Take their time, though, and look at this one. They're saying no good. Bradley Ball.
And did you know, Matt, that you have to have indisputable video evidence
and
to
conclusive.
Overturn?
Yes.
Has a broadcaster ever said that before?
Only a few times.
He didn't get it off. Yeah.
That's conclusive evidence.
Yeah. So Atlasson will come back. More pressure being provided by the Cougars. We'll hand it back to Dean.
At this point, if you're Brian Baroni and SIUE, you say, you do not let Duke Dean beat us the last 3 minutes here. Get somebody on him and do not let him shoot. And they're doing a great job of turning the pressure up. You see Miner right there, very disruptive. It's going to be dribbled out of bounds by Dean. Another turnover there for the Braves.
So good work by Miner. He's fired up. It'll go back over to the Cougars. Yancey.
That's how you use offense, but pretty stagnant the last 5 or 6 possessions. See a nice deflection there by Christian Davis. And just like that, already 10 seconds to operate here for the Cougars. See if they can get a shot here.
Step back jumper is down. And that's what the Cougars can do. Sometimes the ball can get stuck in places, but they have some shot creators and guys that can knock down a shot if they're caught in a situation where the shot clock is dwindling down.
Yeah, without a doubt. And Miner was able to get it done right there. And Bradley working it around the horn. Another open three.
Number 6 for Duke Dean here in the first half.
I mean, Duke Dean is just absolutely on fire. He said, I got fouled too as well. Look at the closeout pin from Thompson. But Duke Dean said, it doesn't matter. It goes in anyways.
All in the first half. He's like Jordan against the Blazers. I'm waiting for him to shrug to us next time he knocks down another one. Lamar Wright.
Nice defense by Atlasson sticking with the play. And yet again, late in the shot clock here for the Cougars. Myers got to put it up.
Another tough shot. This one spins out. And
you better get on
Davis
it now.
The rebound.
Nice pass.
What a pass to Hannah. And it's a good hard foul by Lamar Wright. Let's hope Hannah's okay. He came down crashing hard into the basket. He appears to be all right.
Yeah, definitely a clean play by Lamar Wright. Did a great job getting back. How about the pass from Duke Dean? Threads the needle with the baseball bounce pass. Get another look at this. Beautiful pass. And then you see Wright coming back. Just gets a little bit of the ball, a little bit of the man as well. Hannah crashes into the support there. Going to go to line for two.
So here's Hannah averaging just under 12 points per game. He had tied for a game-high 12 points in the win against the Cougars last year, along with Connor Hickman. Got 3 points so far tonight. That ends a string of 11 straight Bradley points, all scored by Duke Dean. 14 now, beg your pardon, after the last three.
And Hannah, one of the guys we showcased at the top of the show, misses that second free throw. And we talked about his improvements on the offensive end and shooting in a ridiculous 62% field goal percentage this year. Just a guy who has been super consistent on the offensive side of the floor and really improved his aggressiveness on that side of the floor as well.
Nice. They're going to get him a foul first.
We're going to get Duke. That's his first foul of the half. It looked like Miner. It got away picking up that pivot foot. They get another look right here. And the contact is initiated by Miner as well, too. So that's a tough one. Nonetheless, going to stick here with SIUE. 20 seconds to operate. And 7-point game. See if we can get a couple. Well, that's got to be a foul count, too. Really close. Ooh.
And Taylor knocks out a three. So after all that, SIU takes advantage of a questionable call or possession, and they get it back within four, under a minute to play.
And
losing it is Birch, and Miner at the other end. Euros his way in, lost it on his way up, and then a foul on the rebound is going to go on Taylor, I believe. That is the 15th foul on SIUE. So no shots forthcoming yet for Birch, as Anna will quickly come back for Jonovic.
SIUE's on-ball defense has caused a lot of problems here for the Braves in the first half. You see Miner able to get to the bucket, not finish. Nice job by Birch sticking with the play, and Taylor comes in and grabs the foul here. Potential for a 2-for-1 for Bradley if they want it. Might just opt to get a good quality look here to end the half.
Up to Hannah, and that was read well by Polk, but he is whistled for the foul.
And that is a perfectly ran offensive set there from the Braves. Talking about a 16-second differential on the shot and game clock. Able to get a high screen and roll here. Beautiful roll to the hoop and a great lob. And Polk does a good job of coming over and influencing that shot. Bradley is going to get the 2-for-1 opportunity here as Hannah goes to the line for a pair.
It was just there a minute ago, and he's 2-for-3 from the stripe, 4 points. One field goal actually started the ball game. A vicious dunk from Darius Hannah. And 2-for-2 for Darius Hannah. 6.5 second differential, shot clock to game clock.
And Bradley picks up a little bit of zone. Three-quarter court pressure here, just trying to extend this possession, give a different look. You see Reich going down to that corner for a trap. Taylor says, I'll put another one up.
Short, and Atlasson tracks it down.
Bradley's trying to use a timeout.
And Brian Wardle screaming for a timeout.
He was calling that for a good 3 seconds, trying to get that timeout. And that is a mistake right there, too, because it's going to be a jump ball and stick possession. With SIU, they can end the half here with the last shot. Tough break.
Yeah, so as Matt mentioned, shot clock now turned off for the Cougars. And Brian Barone is going to take his first half timeout, use it or lose it here with 19.7 to go. See what they want to draw up. And you look at the first half for SIUE offensively, two players in double figures. Miner and Taylor both have 11.
Taylor's trying to do his best Duke Dean impression. He's right. Got three threes on those 11 points.
Half the amount, however, of Dean's 22 and 6 threes. Whew. But Taylor and Miner both averaging just under 13 points per game. And let's see what they go to here. As we've talked about, they can isolate quite a bit offensively. And with 19.7 to go, let's see if that's what they opt to do here. And let's also see how Bradley comes out defensively. Obviously, we know their base defense and the man-to-man, they're not switching as much tonight, but it might be a scenario where they could change things up, force a second option for SIUE. So let's see what they come out with.
Yeah, without a doubt. I would have to imagine Rayshon Taylor is an elite one-on-one player. He's going to inbound the ball here and maybe get something for him coming out of this, maybe screen his man and then get him an opportunity to go one-on-one to end the half.
Shamar Wright been relatively quiet here in the first half.
They get a switch. So now Taylor on Atlasson. See his lateral defense. See if they're going to run some action up here. Just let him go one-on-one from here. Six to go.
Here does come the screen. driving in and drawing the foul was Taylor with 0.7 to go. Just got a step on Atlasson and forced the Braves to foul.
And you see the athleticism and the burst from Rayshon Taylor. It is absolutely incredible. This is a young man who's gone through a lot of adversities and health-wise. Three injuries, three ACLs, and he's still playing. The last ACL injury came in March in the OVC tournament. A March torn ACL, and he's playing in December. Not just December, he's playing at the beginning of the season, averaging 29 minutes per game played. This guy is just tenacious. He has the will to win, get out there and play. Hats off for him from being healthy and getting out there and making a big impact tonight.
Got 12 in the opener against Ball State. I had to pause because you never know with Duke Dean's first half if that was going to go or not. But Taylor with 13 in the first half for SIUE. But Bradley closes the half strong, and they have a four-point lead heading into the break. We'll step aside, take a timeout. We'll have first half stats, highlights, and more coming up next. You're watching The Valley on ESPN.
New chicken wings make no sense. Marinated in Louisiana spices, hand battered and flipped, and then we have the audacity to call all five flavors fast food? Someone should really say something or order something.
Love that chicken from Popeyes.
Lucky sober body, curly fire up in my chest, got soft skin, hard feelings, give a damn, then give a reason. Pop it, top feeling, been a feeling, been a feeling. Hey. I did it my way.
Hi. Can I open?
When you don't want to take a vacation from working out, it matters where you stay.
What's up, Peloton? Welcome to your 80s ride.
Peloton bikes are arriving soon at every hotel in the Hilton family of brands. Hilton, for the stay.
With no fees or minimums and no overdraft fees, banking with Capital One is the easiest decision in the history of decisions. Even easier than this.
All right, who's going to deliver the toys to the kids?
Yoo-hoo!
No. Sarah, you do it.
Really?
Yeah.
You steal the presents one time.
I've stolen them no times.
With no fees or minimums and no overdraft fees, is it even a decision? That's banking reimagined. What's in your wallet?
Pictures of Max. Yuck.
Remember in school when you learn complicated math stuff like sine and cosine and you think, will I ever use this in real life? Well, the answer is no. But a kettlebell squat, well, that's the opposite of whatever cosine is.
Halftime at Carver Arena with the Braves out to a four-point lead over the SIUE Cougars. And forget, NBC student-athletes are positively impacting the communities where they live by sharing views and fostering a climate for change for future Valley pioneers. To learn more about mobilizing voices for change, visit nbc-sports.com/onevalley. And Matt, highlights are not sponsored by Duke Dean, but they might as well be after his incredible performance in that first half. 22 first half points. His teammates obviously contributed too, but how about the half from Dean?
Yeah, Dean was absolutely unconscious. Got to give SIUE a lot of credit though as well too. As much as Dean did, the 22 points in the half. Just 17 other points from Bradley. You see Christian Davis with the three there. Darius Hanna had the dunk early on. But the Cougars have done a good job of staying within striking distance. Yancey knocked down a triple and a great putback dunk there by Thompson. Obviously an excellent first half from both Miner and Taylor. But other than that, it was the Duke Dean show, and just absolutely unconscious. It didn't matter if there was somebody on him, didn't have a big man burn out to close out. Just all over the place, 6 of 8 from behind the three-point arc for Duke Dean. And that performance in the first half has Bradley with a four-point advantage here at the halftime break.
9 threes in the first half for the Braves, and as Matt mentioned, 6 from Duke Dean. We'll step aside, take a timeout. We'll take a look at more of the numbers here on the second segment. Coming up next with the Braves up 4 right here on the Valley on ESPN.
For the DQ chicken strip basket. Oh, just $6.99 for the whole basket. But it's only for a limited time?
Let's go get it right now.
I'm driving. DQ, happy tastes good.
Lucky sober body, curly fire up in my chest, got soft skin, hard feelings, give a damn, then give a reason, pop it, top, feeling, been a feeling, been a feeling. I did it my way.
Hill and Honors slays.
Obsessed.
Points for a freeze day? Yes, please.
Upgrade.
Loves it.
All these perks. We're sliving.
Totally sliving. I said that right?
Yeah.
When you want the celebrity treatment, no matter who you are, it matters.
Insist it's regulation height, even though it's definitely not.
I will insist it's regulation height, even though it's definitely not.
Excellent. Kingpin thanks you for your loyalty.
Your discretion is advised. On January 9th, all 5 episodes, one killer dropped.
I wouldn't have it any other way.
Only on Hulu and Disney Plus. Marvel Studios Echo. All episodes streaming January 9th.
Articles.
.39-35 is the score. Bradley on top of SIUE as the Missouri Valley is taking on the Ohio Valley tonight here in Peoria. We showed you the highlights. Let's take a look at some of the numbers, Matt. And from your lens, what really stands out here in the first half?
Yeah, Bradley did a really good job of facilitating. Obviously, the 13 field goals, 8 assists, that's been something that they've kind of struggled a little bit with this year. They're talking about, you know, the assist to field goal ratio, and a lot of it playing into that has been turnovers as well. Bradley actually has more turnovers than assists this season. So Bradley does have 9 turnovers in that first half. Something that was a key to the game. Didn't clean that up as well. The rebounding advantage, you know, we talked about SIUE, that being a big key for them. Bradley actually wins the rebounds in the first half. And the Cougars doing a good job of, sometimes their offense, we talked about, has the tendency to be stagnant, maybe a little one-on-one driven, but they're getting to the free throw line. 10 free throws in the first half. You see them shooting 90%, knocking down 9 out of 10. So doing a good job of staying within striking distance and keeping this a close game in the first half, despite the first half heroics from Duke Dean and Braves.
Well, it's no secret, Matt, too, that the Braves in a skid heading into tonight, starting 6-0, dropped the last 5, but you know, offense, defense, you see some of the numbers overall, and you know, that's kind of where we stand and what things have shifted over the last few days. And again, it's still early on in the season, but we've seen some changes in the first 6 for the second 5.
Yeah, and great job by our producers, hot and cold. They knew that they needed to use Duke Dean on the graphic for the hot one.
Right.
It's really simple, right? So you're going to score more and allow fewer points when you're winning, and when you're losing, it could go the opposite direction. Those numbers prove that right here. But what this really shows us is that, you know, Bradley's been in a lot of close games. They've played some really, really good competition so far this season, and despite the fact they've had an injury to a star in Connor Hickman, they're getting some more experience from guys on the bench, and they're really trying to find a little bit of their identity and some chemistry with different rotations. Look, Bradley's defense has to improve. That's where they hang their hat. You know, compete, defend, rebound, that's a Brian Wardle team. That's what they want to do. The defense has to get better. Tonight, the offense has been excellent, on pace for 78 points. If that continues, they're going to keep winning more and more basketball games.
And they held a four-point lead that's led by as many as seven here in the first half. Second half of action, it's not far away, so don't go anywhere. 39-35 is the score. We'll be back for the second half of action between Bradley and SIUE. That's coming at you next.
The Home Depot, committed to filling the trade gap.
$5 duo at Burger King. Double up flavors when hunger dings. Whopper Jr. and Royal Crispy Wraps for a lunch, dinner, dinner, or late night snack.
BK, have it your way.
Lucky soul, body curly, fry up in my chest, got soft skin, hard feelings. Give a damn, then give a reason. Pop it, top feeling, been a feeling, been a feeling. I did it my way.
I will not break a sweat when I take the stairs.
I will not break a sweat when I take the stairs.
I will dunk on the hoop over my garage.
I will dunk on the hoop over my garage.
I will insist it's regulation height, even though it's definitely not.
I will insist it's regulation height, even though it's definitely not.
Excellent.
Try fast and always free drive up at Target.
Huh. How long have you been tracking our car's value with Carvana?
Just like 7 months.
Should we sell it?
We hold.
Hold.
Silver vans are going for more right now. Should we?
Hold.
Our low mileage is paying off. You think we should?
Hold.
Depreciation's really heating up. You think?
Hold.
We just did 2.5%.
Hold. Now.
I'm on it.
Already sold to Carvana.
Go to Carvana and track your car's value today.
The score here in Peoria at halftime. A very mild night. It's going to be mild for Christmas, it seems like, in Illinois this year.
It's fine by me.
I'm fine with it.
Maybe snow once on Christmas, and then
yeah,
we're good.
I don't know if we're going to get it.
I don't know if we're going to get it.
But you look at upcoming schedules. It said at the top of the broadcast, Cougars will begin Ohio Valley play next Friday when they take on Eastern Illinois. That'll be the first game. They don't do kind of what the NBC does, where they have that minor start to the Valley season due to not as many teams in the league. But Eastern Illinois will be there, and you see Western. They'll go against all sorts of directional Illinois schools before taking on Little Rock, Southern Indiana, and Morehead State.
Yeah, and how about that for an opportunity to open up conference play? Four of your first five at home, really come out and set the tone for the conference season. And I mean, if they play like they're playing tonight, they're gonna have a great opportunity to pick up some wins in those first five.
Yeah, we talked about SIUE's preseason second in OVC poll, the preseason favorite Morehead State, so that'll be a big one coming up in mid-January for the Cougars. Shifting gears to Bradley, so after tonight, they'll have one non-conference match game available, and that'll be against Truman State a week from tonight. And then we'll get back into Valley play. And I know the Braves, you know, starting 0-2 in the league, they're hungry to get back into that. Of course, they want to take care of business tonight and next Thursday, but want to avenge a couple of those early conference season losses, and they'll have a chance to do so against Valpo, and then we'll be back at home against Missouri State for the next home Valley matchup.
Look, it's a long Missouri Valley conference season. Hey, teams that start 0-2 are going to have an opportunity to compete for a championship. Teams that are 2-0 might be near the bottom. So it's kind of having one of those short-term memory losses, restart and say, hey, you know what, we're going to the Valley playing now. They got another half of basketball here. They got a game against Truman State. Let's reset. Let's focus. And you know what? It is a long couple months in January and February to lead up into Arch Madness down in St. Louis for the Valley Tournament. Brad's going to have a lot of really good games coming down here in the stretch run.
Yeah, and come on down to Carver Arena.
Please.
There's some really good basketball games that are going to be played on this floor in the coming months. We know the league is deep this year, and there's going to be a lot of teams, as Matt mentioned, they're going to have the opportunity to compete for a regular season championship. Of course, Bradley included in that, but we mentioned, talked about some of those teams in Missouri State and Belmont that we have coming up that expect to be competitive this year. Evansville's off to a really good start as well this season. So it should be a fun year. The return match against Murray State later on in January. Northern Iowa's here as well. They've really tested themselves in non-conference play too, so really looking forward to getting back into to league play. But first things first, we got 60 more minutes of game action and non-conference slate as the Braves are going to run out Hartke, Dean, Hannah, Leons, and Davis to start the second half.
And remember, we didn't see too much of Malvi Leons. Is he going to get the opportunity right here to go one-on-one? The double comes over. Foul and one. Put it down for Malvi Leons, who did not play too much late there in the second half, picking up two fouls, and does a good job of getting right back into the action here early in the second half.
Yeah, that's really a double whammy for SIUE, because not only did they give up the and one in the first possession, they also, I believe, have Lamar Wright picking up his third foul, and he's quite the defensive presence down there. So three fouls for him. Leons gets the bucket, and the Braves have scored on the opening possessions of both halves, both drawn up beautifully and executed perfectly. And they open up a 7-point lead, which matches their largest of the night.
See, Darius Hand did a really good job of trying to fight through that screen and get out and, you know, influence that shot. But it's one of those that you're going to go out and foul a three-point shooter. It's a really, really tough one. Shamar right now goes to the line for three free throws on a, honestly, pretty well-defended play, but just a lack of concentration there.
And Wright back to the stripe. The redshirt senior out of Memphis misses the first. This team returns over 60% of their minutes from last year. A lot of vets on this team, as we've mentioned, as Wright has come up empty in the first two. Came in at a very respectable 74%. And he misses.
Oh my goodness. Wow.
I
do think it was a foul, but it's one of those ball don't lie. Okay, but let's give Darius Hand the benefit of the doubt. Okay, there was no ill will there. All right, well, no, none of these free throws are going in.
So the Braves get
a
break.
No way.
And the length of Wright all over Duke Dean as Hannah puts it on the floor. Picks it back out. Hartke's three is too strong. And Shamar Wright, the rebound. He's averaging over 4 per contest. And Miner will back his way in on Dean, trying to turn baseline, and pulls it back out.
Yeah, Dean doing a good job there, standing his ground. Now they're going to get Thompson a touch. And great job there by Hartke, coming from behind, poking that one away. The Braves in transition.
Spinning in is Hannah. He lost his balance and travel.
Yeah, a lot of contact there on the pivot. Hannah trying to spin away from the contact, picks up the pivot foot. You're going to get called for a travel. You see another look at it. Nice bounce pass. And a travel turnover for the Braves. And that was something they really struggled with again in the first half, 9 turnovers. That's now their 10th turnover in just 21 minutes of play.
Bursting by is Miner, and he draws the foul.
Really heads-up move there by Miner. You see that a lot at the highest level of basketball, the NBA, when a guard gets past his defender and feels that pressure, just kind of slam on the brakes a little bit, draw the contact as he's going up for the shot, gets fouled, earns the trip to the line where we know he is prolific.
Now 6 of 7 from the line. Birch is going to come in for Hartke. Miner now with 12 points, right at his season average. It's such a rarity when you think of a 6 foot guard to have 4 double-doubles. Yeah. And not only 4 double-doubles, but all of those are points and rebounds. Right?
Lead the team in rebounding at 9 per game, and a guy who's just absolutely tenacious. And as you mentioned, a unicorn and great defender as well.
He's 7th in the nation in rebound percentage, and he's a 6 foot guard. It's just nearly unheard of. As Leon's with the floater, too strong, and the rebound goes to Taylor. 5-point lead for Bradley. It was 4 at the break. Taylor is fouled by Davis.
Yeah, and you know, Christian Davis is kind of sticking with him, but one thing he never does there is force Taylor to stop his momentum. You got to stop the ball in transition. Taylor's able to get deep, get into the lane, gets Davis on his hip, gets to the free throw line. Really, really nice move. Heads up play by the veteran Taylor.
So Taylor, who is tied with Miner with 13 points. This will be his 3rd and 4th foul shots of the night. Comes up empty on the first. Cougars as a team now 11 of 16 from the line. Bradley at 5 of 7. Braves shooting overall at 52%. At halftime, we're on pace for 78 points. SIUE has held 8 of their 12 opponents under 70 this year. Bradley on pace to eclipse that early on. Still plenty of time to go, I get it, but good first half offensively for the Braves.
Yeah, Duke Dean hasn't even taken a shot yet in the, right? second half. That might change.
It does. And he buries his 7th three of the night. It's one shy of this, the Bradley all-time record in a single game.
You know, they say the curse of the commentator. Sometimes it just lines up like that, or it just works for you. And now Dean, he's got that look in his eyes, scanning the floor. This might go up on this possession here.
Then it gives to Leon. Spins, nearly lost it. Good help by Taylor on the floor. I believe we're going to get a tie
time
up.
Timeout. They word it, yep. Got Taylor able to get the timeout. Keep possession here for the Cougars.
So timeout, it will stay with SIUE, so no jump ball. But first we'll call timeout of the second half. It'll stretch to a full. We'll take it with him. Duke Dean now up to 25 points on 7 threes. He leads all scorers, shockingly enough, and the Braves have a 7-point lead early on in half number 2.
Grill, located inside the Holiday Inn & Suites Peoria at Grand Prairie.
Bradley University student-athletes live their sport, so when an injury occurs, they need a team of specialists focused and ready to get them back in action. The sports medicine doctors at OSF Healthcare, in partnership with Great Plains Orthopedics, are specially trained to restore function to injured athletes so they can get back to competing as soon as possible. OSF Healthcare and Great Plains Orthopedics are proud to be the official sports medicine providers for Bradley Athletics.
Derek Henry.
Hey, Jake from State Farm. I saved so much bundling, it inspired my workout. Auto! Home!
Okay, and this is auto again, right?
Auto!
Hey, this is my living room.
Home!
Bundling, just another way to save with the personal price plan.
The dog isn't allowed on the couch, Derek.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Welcome to Toyotathon.
Hi, I want a new Toyota for a weekend getaway. You know, recharge from the holidays.
Perfect, we've got new vehicles arriving daily.
Excuse me, I have got a truckload of new Toyotas up front.
A truckload of new Toyotas?
Come on, man. I want one.
Something I said?
Yes.
right now, you can get 3.99% APR financing plus $1,000 cash back on a new Tacoma when you finance through Toyota Financial Services.
Toyota-thon ends January 2nd.
Toyota, let's go places.
45-38 is the score, and you know, Duke Dean now just 1-3 away from tying the single game record in program history, which has been done five different times, most recently by Danny Adams back in the 06 season. Our guy DA, he might be in attendance tonight.
That's
he
a good it. Chance.
And Anthony Parker also did it.
Yeah.
As well. But
Anthony Manuel has a pretty good list of three-point shooters. And it's not the only feat so far tonight for Duke Dean as well. We asked Sports Information Director Cody Roskins to do a little work for us. Last time a Bradley player scored 20 points in one half, you could have guessed his name's in the rafters. It's the Hawk. Percy Hawkins did it several times
in
1988.
I'll check my notes to figure out who that is.
Yeah, exactly. Number 33, may have heard of him. But it's been, 35 years since a player scored 20 points in a half. Duke Dean now joins that list with Percy Hawkins just absolutely on fire here in the opening 23 minutes of the game.
He's one shy of a career high, as we mentioned earlier in the broadcast, had 26 against Stonehill last year.
And Miner is going to be draped all over him. We saw a couple of defensive stops in the first half from Miner, able to get inside of Dean's breadbasket a little bit there and just a little too tight on the foul. Now he is going to be trailing him, though, and maybe if they can get Duke Dean coming off a couple of screens and then work some mismatches, try to overplay that commitment from the SIU trying to prevent him from scoring.
Deflection by the Cougars. Birch leans in and scores. He's got five on a perfect 2 of 2 from the floor. The freshman from Milwaukee gives Bradley their largest lead of the night at 9. Shamar Wright backing his way in. Good move, influenced by Leons, who comes away with the rebound. That's his 6 to go along with 5 points. Now here's Dean, gets a step. Looking for Leons, top of the circle. Back behind the back, out to Birch. Side steps, hands to Hannah for the flush.
Love the extra passes in that possession. Two great jobs of passing up decent looks, and how about that finish there? Great pass down low and the two-handed flush for Hannah.
Up to a double-digit affair for the Braves. Miner goes up and draws the foul. So Miner doing what he does, and that's getting to the foul line. He'll have two more when we come back. 15:47 to go. The Braves have opened up an 11-point lead here in Peoria on the Valley on ESPN.
And Doug.
Customize and save with Liberty Bibberty. Liberty Booshima. Liberty Blibitu.
Mark that one. That was nice.
I think you're supposed to stand over there.
Oh, am I? Thank you.
So a couple more, but we'll go quick.
Libru smibu. Libru bribu. Limu bibu. And me.
He's an emu!
Only pay?
$5 duo at Burger King. Double up flavors when hunger dings. Whopper Jr. and Royal Crispy Wraps for a lunch, dinner, or late night snack.
BK, have it your way.
So robotic, curly, fry up in my chest, got soft skin, hard feelings, give a damn, then give a reason, pop it, top feeling, been a feeling, been a feeling. Alright, okay, I did it my way.
I will not break a sweat when I take the stairs.
I will not break a sweat when I take the stairs.
I will dunk on the hoop over my garage.
I will dunk on the hoop over my garage.
I will insist it's regulation height, even though it's definitely not.
I will insist it's regulation height, even though it's definitely not.
Excellent.
Bradley with an 11-point lead, and Arch Madness will be here before you know it. The 2024 State Farm MVC Men's Basketball Tournament marks 30 years at Enterprise Center. Mark your calendars for March 7th through 10th and celebrate 30 years of Arch Madness at Enterprise Center. Get your all-session tickets tonight and save nearly $25 by calling 309-677-2625 or order online at bradleybraves.com. Support the Braves and experience the madness. I'm experiencing some Duke Dede madness tonight, Matt McClain. I know we keep talking about it, but, I mean, it's been a ridiculous night for number 21 in the white scripted uniforms and 25 for Dean, but a really, really good night for DeMarco Minor as well on the flip side, now with 14 points. And the Braves have made him earn it because he's just 3 of 9 from the field, but 8 of 9 from the foul line, and he'll make it 9 of 10 for the junior from Chicago.
Yeah, without a doubt, and that's just so, like, clutch to be able to say, all right, we're in a little bit of a scoring rut. You know what? I'm going to the free throw line. I'm just going to take advantage and, you know, kind of dictate and say, hey, you're going to draw contact and get to the line. Let's go get some points. And doing a good job of keeping the Cougars within striking distance here.
This time, Leon tries a three. It's contagious.
Yeah, and just a really, really good offensive set there. That's a simple little pick and roll, and Thompson is late to adjust to get out onto the shooter. Got to know the game plan, KYP, and know your personnel. And Leon's knocks down the wide open three.
Gray's able to get in here and practice yesterday here at the Civic Center and get some shots up, made some paying dividends as Davis gets his hand in the passing lane, stripped right back by Minor. 3-on-1, laid up and in with the left by Shamar Wright.
Yeah, really unfortunate because Davis did everything right on the defensive end. Gets to the other end, trying to attack, and gets stripped. Great job by Taylor, and gets it ahead to Wright. And really a kind of potential four-point swing there for Bradley, and a big bucket for SIUE.
Allison is off the mark.
Oh, and that's really rare, too, because Allison, one of the premier three-point shooters in the country, Brian, coming into the game, 18 of 37 from three. A resounding 49% and doesn't even draw iron on that one.
Yeah, 42nd in the country in three-point percentage heading into tonight. Thompson hands it right back to Miner.
You gotta imagine with Davis on him, maybe try to get downhill a little bit, get back to the line instead off to Taylor.
Good defensive sequence thus far by the Braves. Step back jumper is a tough one, and it's knocked down by Taylor. Another difficult three by him.
Yeah, and Taylor's had an excellent night from the floor. Knocked down a handful of three-pointers. That's another one there as Dean facilitates a couple extra passes.
That one spins out, and it finds the arms of Miner. And the Braves want to carry. They don't get it. Blocked by Davis. Taylor gets it back. Teardrop blocked by Leons. And the Braves collect this one. Let's see if they push the other way. Dean hands to Birch, and he stepped down the sideline. And I don't think Birch agreed, but it will turn back over to SIUE.
That's now 13 turnovers for Bradley coming off of the season high 19 last time out against Duquesne. And it's just one of those that we talked to Brian Wardle pregame, and he even mentioned to us, he's like, I'd much rather have a missed shot than a turnover. And, you know, Bradley really has to clean that up as they head into Valley play.
And SIUE on the flip side, as they turn it over, I was just about to say, they do a great job at taking, that's been one of their strengths for the Cougars this year. They're actually 22nd in the country at taking care of the basketball, at least the rate of doing so, but they do turn it over here. And it'll go back to Bradley as Atlas and William bound.
Yeah, well, you talk about that efficiency and being able to take care of the basketball. Only 14% of their possessions end in a turnover, which is just ridiculous.
Really
ridiculous. And the national D1 average is 18%. You just think about how many possessions you do. The difference of that 4% is extravagant. You see a missed three,
that's,
and Jonovic staying active.
Yeah, it's gonna. Birch was right there going after it, and he was pulled to the ground. And it'll be out of bounds underneath. Both teams now with four team fouls here in the half. And Birch to inbound. Up top for Leons. He puts it on the floor,
he's,
and he was
him.
Grabbed
yeah.
on his way in. And that's another foul, and just the second on Taylor.
Team foul 5 on SIUE. Bradley on the other end with 4 here. And another fresh 20 for the Braves to operate.
Lamar Wright's been on the bench for quite some time because he has 3 fouls. Birch, the baseline kicked out and a foul on the pass.
Oh man, three fouls this possession for SIUE. It's really working Bradley towards the one in bonus. They're gonna be there the rest of the half now, with 13 minutes left.
One on one, spinning in his layups, and there is really nothing Taylor can do. Didn't want to pick up his third foul. Wright just picked up his third, Shamar Wright that is.
And Malachi Leon just absolutely put him in the spin cycle right there, flushes it. And a big, big momentum shift right now. Bradley, the 9-point lead. See if their defense can get another stop.
Sakanis. And his grill is Dean. Taylor gets his man in the air and he's hit on his way up.
And that's really tough from Taylor as well too. Just making something out of nothing. It looked like maybe a dead possession. Spins away, gets his defender up off the ground. Taylor going back to the free throw line where, I mean, between him and Miner, just absolutely lived here on the charity stripe here.
That's what is keeping them within striking distance, as the Braves have held SIUE to just 36% from the floor. They came in shooting over 45% from the field.
And we talked about SIUE doing such a great job getting to the free throw line. First half, shooting 90% at that 9 of 10 clip. And now here in the second half, 6 of 11. So they have left some points off of the scoreboard there from the free throw line. And an 8-point deficit, those points are absolutely massive. A lot of contacts.
Yeah, Taylor, and that is his third.
And Birch will go to the line now. Bradley's in the bonus the rest of the game.
So three on Taylor, both Shamar and Lamar Wright.
Yeah, you get in there, look at this. Jonovic coming up to set the screen, and Taylor's expecting contact from the other side and just gets tripped up, trips up Birch. And an opportunity to go to the line here.
Good minutes off the bench tonight from the freshman, Demarion Birch. He now has 6 points, 2 rebounds, 3 assists. Of course, a top 10 recruit in the state of Wisconsin last year, a prolific scorer in high school, and you certainly see the potential in this young freshman here in Peoria.
It's just so effortless. He's got a quick, quick might be an understatement. He is just absolutely rapid first step. He can get to the lane at will at times, and he's going to take a little time to develop, but the intangibles and raw potential is definitely there for Demarion Birch. And you see right there, that's one of those. You're fast, you got the lateral movement, use the hands on a drive, and that's where SIUE has been really, really trying to get downhill. And a foul there from Birch.
This one's been called a lot more tight here in the second half. Now 13 fouls combined here in the opening 8 minutes.
And both teams will be going to the line from fouls from here on out too. That was Bradley's sixth. Next one will put him in the one in bonus. You see Bradley out of this timeout, out of this sideline, out of bounds play, goes to the 1-2-2 zone. And SIUE having a hard time adjusting.
Yancey had it picked away, blocked by Jonovic on the attempt by Sakanis, and the shot clock expires. And a good changeup by the Braves throws SIUE off a little bit on that last trip. And the Braves will have it with 11:51 to go, leading by 9 right here in the Valley on ESPN.
BK, have it your way. Your
soft skin, hard feelings, give a damn, then give a reason. Pop it, top feeling, been a feeling, been a feeling. Alright, okay, I did it my way.
I avoided credit cards most of my life, but when I started to create a streaming platform for musicians like me, I knew it was important to build my credit to set my business up right. I heard about the Chime Credit Builder card and I signed up right away. I didn't have to worry about fees, interest, or credit checks. Within a month, my score went up. Now it's up over 100 points. I feel set up for success and so is my business. I tell everybody about the Chime Credit Builder card. Here we go. Check it out at chime.com.
They call me the hot chocolate guru. Okay, nobody calls me that. But...
Oh, no.
Oh. I've got this.
Bradley with a 9-point lead over SIU-Edwardsville. If you're just joining us, the Cougars led for a decent portion of that first half. The Braves went on a run, had a 4-point halftime lead. They've led by as many as 11 here in the second half, but don't expect the Cougars to lay down. This is a program that fights. We know we talked about them having their most wins or winning a season since moving to a Division I program last year, just shy of 20 wins. Preseason second, and Matt, that just kind of leads me in my point about the schedule that Bradley has really tested themselves in has been pretty remarkable. Every single game, they're going up against a team that thinks they are have a chance to win their respective league, all in the top four in the preseason polls, an experienced group, these programs that typically have shown winning prowess the last couple of years as Birch comes up empty. And you look at strength of schedule in the Valley, it's Northern Iowa and Bradley at the top, and then everyone else
without
as far as like the opponents they've played. It's been glaring the difference in the quality of opponents, and hopefully this is something that will help the Braves out throughout the season.
Oh, without a doubt. Talk about getting battle tested in your first, you know, dozen games or whatnot. The NBA has a new stat, clutch games, and it's a 5-point contest within 5 minutes left in the game. You see Jonovic missing the bunny, and great hustle from Lance.
Look at the hustle by Lance. A foul. I think you're going to call a foul.
Wow. Overall, great hustle. Coach Baroni was wanting over and back.
And it's going to go on Miner. Or Birch. No, I think it's going to go on Miner.
It should be Miner. It'll be one-on-one for the Braves. Or one in bonus for the Braves, rather. You get another look at this. Jonovic unable to get it to go. Look at Leon's just sprint to get two touches on that. And Coach Baroni may have a case there for over and back. There is a loose ball foul. Unable to see when that was called. Nonetheless, Leon's is going to the free throw line.
Top 100 in the country in free throw rate, just meaning he gets to the line more than almost everyone in the nation. At least everyone except for top 99. He does miss the front end. But to put a bow on it, Matt, you look at, I know, of course, Bradley isn't happy with the recent results and the 0-2 record in Valley play. As laying one up and in.
Nicely done.
Is Sakanis. Is Braves with still an opportunity to go to 8-3 in non-conference play if they're able to hold on to this one and then take down Truman State. So plenty of time to do that, but that would be very impressive given the record or the quality of opponents they've had early on.
Yeah, without a doubt. And Bradley in those close games, we're talking about a 5-point game within 5 minutes left. 7 of their 11 games have been that, and they're 5-2. They have a 5-2 record in those close games. So just talking about being battle tested, you see Hannah gets that bucket to go. He's got 9. And they are just extremely battle tested, without a doubt, in this non-conference.
So they have reopened a 9-point lead, and they get the steal. Leon's looking for some help. He gives it to Dean. The Braves look to extend back to double figures. Under 10 to play.
Bradley can get Dean a look here as he goes downhill, stops and pops.
And he's got a new career high with 27 points. Come on, Duke, that's only worth 2, man.
I mean, he's just absolutely on fire. It doesn't matter. It doesn't seem like it matters if it's a 2 or a 3 or a 40-footer that he made in the first half. It's everything's going in. And Bradley drops back into this 1-2-2 zone again, causing a lot of problems here for SIUE.
Right. Entry down low to Sakanis. Great help by Hardkey, and that forces the turnover. Dean is bumped.
Yancey was trying to be a vulture there. Just be a little sly getting back in transition. Sees that pass going to Dean. Tries to play the passing lane. I love the hustle
limp
there. Yep.
I hit him in the hip. Yancey's head that hit him kind of in that left hip. Seems to be all right. He'll shoot one to the bonus. 19 foul on the Cougars.
As you mentioned, already has the career high. Breaking it with that last field goal. And now the opportunity to add on to it. Duke Dean going to the line for 2.
So Lamar Wright, who again has been limited tonight due to some foul issues, will come back in.
Excuse me, this is still the one in bonus.
And doesn't get it to go, keeps it alive.
And 15 to shoot now for the Braves. Dean being guarded by Lamar Wright. Gets the ball screen, pick and pop in the corner, lands for three. Well off the mark, chased down by Taylor. Let's see if the Cougars push it. Miner is cut off. One-on-one, Miner step back, top of the circle, three is good.
Really, really tough. And that's the reigning defensive player of the year in the Missouri Valley Conference, Malavi Lance guarding him. And Miner has been excellent tonight for SIUE, knocking down that triple now.
Thompson on Dean. Dean going baseline, has it deflected out of bounds. It'll stay with Bradley with 14 to shoot. And Birch will come in for Dean.
For a little bit of a screen to screener. Nonetheless, actually it's Lance going to the hoop. The left hand doesn't get to go in, and SIUE now maybe looking for a little bit of momentum. This would make it a 5-point game. No good.
And Davis collects his third rebound.
And Coach Worrell wanting Brad to pick up the pace here a little bit, and Birch knows how to do that.
In the corner, here's Harkey. There's a three for Cade Harkey, his first triple. And he reopens a double-digit lead for the Braves as Lamar Wright is fouled at the other end.
Harkey doing an excellent job of knocking down the three off the penetration from Birch. And then really good job by SIUE, you know, knocking down, gets to the other end of the floor, say, hey, I'm going to get to the free throw line after the three ball. As Bradley up 62-51, under 8 minutes to go. Should be an exciting finish here down the stretch in the Valley on the ESPN.
Bradley University student athletes live their sport, so when an injury occurs, they need a team of specialists focused and ready to get them back in action. The sports medicine doctors at OSF Healthcare, in partnership with Great Plains Orthopedics, are specially trained to restore function to injured athletes so they can get back to competing as soon as possible. OSF Healthcare and Great Plains Orthopedics are proud to be the official sports medicine providers for Bradley Athletics.
Bar and Grill, located inside the Holiday Inn & Suites Peoria at Grand Prairie.
With Matt McClain, I am Brian Beto back here. 62-51 is the score. And if you're just joining us, know your eyes are not deceiving you. The Bradley coaching staff wearing what they call ugly Christmas sweaters. But as we've said, we respect the drip tonight from for the Braves staff, Brian Baroni as well doing that. And his team down, Brian Baroni's team down 11 here. We'll have two free throws forthcoming for Lamar Wright. Duke Dean already with a career high 27 points. The Braves have 12 threes as a team. Dean with seven of those. But talk about the three-point shooting, Matt. Something that's been a strength tonight. And something that we expect to be a strength for this team this season, really, is this is a really good shooting team, and they expect that to be an area where they can have a ton of success as we get through league play the rest of the year, too.
Yeah, without a doubt. Got some prolific three-point shooters. We've obviously seen it from Dean tonight. Almar Atlason's had a game this year, knocked down six triples. We've seen Malavi Leon's knock down some. Christian Davis shoots at an extremely high clip, 40% three-point shooter as well, too, so that three ball, obviously, in today's day and age of the analytics, is king. And Bradley has the squad to really compete in the MVC thanks to that three-point shooting.
It's Lamar Wright, believe it or not. That was his first point of the ball game. Again, hasn't played his normal allotment of minutes due to some foul trouble. Jonovic in, looking high-low for Leons. He draws the double, forced to get it through. Back up top, Harkey, his three. Tipped up, no good. Chased down by Taylor.
And now you're going to see SIUE start picking up the pace. They got to get to the hoop. They got to get something going just on cue. And then hit the rim.
Not sure if that was Jonovic or Leons, but either way, it looked to be like it was going to be either an easy two or at least a foul coming up. But Bradley gets the clean block. It remains SIUE basketball as Birch comes back in for Hartke. 20 on the shot clock still.
Yeah, that was a great job by kind of a gang defensive stop right there. And Meta's going to get a little bit of a breather as well. He was involved on that block. And it looked like Wright was going to say, like you said, Brian, it can have an easy two-handed slam for Lamar Wright. But it's going to stay with the Cougars here now, 20 to go. Trying to look for the post there is Wright on Leons.
They go over the top. There is Lamar Wright. Power dribble, and he draws the foul.
And they're asking for offensive goaltend as well, too, because Bradley went through the net, it looked like. And nonetheless, asking for him to look at it. And may have a point on this one.
I don't think anyone saw the officials can read body language. It looks like they're shaking their heads like nobody saw it.
Yeah, it's going to be a standard foul. No goaltending and just two free throws here for Lamar Wright.
Wright is 65% foul shooter. He's now 2 of 3 from the line. And again, they certainly miss his score, nearly 11 points per game, but he's such a shot influence on the other end as well. He's fourth all-time in program history in blocked shots.
Already with 16 blocked shots this season coming into the game. And unable to get one so far tonight, but those stats do not lie. And now Brad's going to have a 5-on-4 here as Miner picked up a knock on the other end.
Great inside-out game for Birch. Tipped back to Birch. This time puts it on the floor, gets in the lane. Short baseline, back to Dean. Dean guarded by Miner.
Time to go shot hunting.
Off left this time. Fires it, holding the lap of Davis, who lays it in.
Yeah, and it looked like Thompson had a great box out on Hannah. All he's got to do is explode, go up, and get the ball for the rebound. But Hannah able to high point the ball, volleyball spike it down, and the easy put in for the Braves.
8 points now for Davis to go along with 6 boards. Thompson hands to Taylor. Tough contested three, tipped up, no. Miner the rebound, back out to Lamar Wright. Run off the three-point line, and now his 9th rebound for Malibu Leon.
And Brad's gonna start slowing it up here. We're using some of these 30-second shot clocks. Got a 10-point lead with 6 minutes to go. Now it's just about, you know, facilitating on the offensive end, getting good looks, and really killing this game off.
Birch nearly had it poked away. Had it deflected out. Great job by Dean to come away with it. Birch in the corner, a three. Hannah there for the offensive rebound. Tries the reverse. He had it blocked.
Sticks with
out
it.
To Dean, and he thought about it. Instead pulls it out with Bradley holding a 10-point edge. And a long possession. This would be deflating for SIUE if the Braves can score here. Dean, step back, three, short. Davis cleans it up.
4 chances for Bradley, a 45-second possession, and Christian Davis sticks with it. Another offensive rebound chance for the Braves. What a possession for Bradley to put him up by a dozen. That was just all effort. You know, Bradley crashing the glass, working the second chance, third chance, fourth chance opportunity. And that is just an absolute killer. As you see, Taylor, and you talk about a killer, a guy who just gets to the rim. Quick first step, and a 20-point performance for Rayshon Taylor.
On the pick and roll. Hannah, skip to the corner. Up top, Davis. Here's Dean. The ball keeps moving. And Dean is too strong.
Offensive rebound.
Leons is left open.
A Big possession here for SIUE. Opportunity to get it within 10. There's a 10-point game now, but there's the defensive player of the year, Leon, with the steal.
Giving it to Davis, who lays it in.
That's just too good. That's all Malvi Leon's right there. And facilitating and getting it done on the defensive end, getting out in transition, and another stop, and it's going to be Rice sticking with it.
Davis now with the last six for the Braves. All on layups at the rim. And that's the fourth on Leon's. And with that last rebound by Leon's, he's got 10 points, 10 rebounds. Now back-to-back double-doubles for Leon's, the 10th of his career.
Hey, get another look. You're talking about his tenacity on the defensive end and the unselfishness. Davis running the floor, doing an excellent job. You mentioned the last six, all from Christian Davis. And they've come from second chance opportunities, out in transition. Nicely done. And those are not boos. Those are Dukes. As Duke Dean gets a nice hand from the Carver Arena faithful. And checking out of the ball game as Wright knocks down the free throw. Point contest, less than 4 minutes to go. Brad doing a nice job of slowing things down here, working a quality look. Open three for Atlasson, and passes it up for another three look.
Great looks at it. Just kept able to knock
again.
It down the last couple minutes, but the effort is certainly there, and a good effort, and it's going to be a tie-up possession. Bradley wanted the timeout. They didn't get it, and it's going to be a jump ball, and it'll go back over to the Cougars. When we come back, 3:38 to go in this one. Bradley up 10, trying to close out SIUE on the Valley on ESPN.
You can feel confident Continental is the smart choice in tires.
Can they handle extremes?
Yep. Tested from the Texas desert to near the Arctic Circle.
Really?
Really.
Anything for the guy who finds that one pothole?
Yeah. Road hazard coverage has your back.
For real?
Absolutely.
Were they made by, like, a bajillion engineers?
Well, closer to 100. Continental. Welcome to the Smart Choice in Tires.
What's in your wallet?
Brian Beato, Matt McClain back with you. Well, the Braves have cooled off a little bit in the second half from the perimeter, but it's been the extra effort by Bradley on the offensive glass that's really allowed them to keep SIUE at arm's length with 4 minutes to go.
Duke Dean missing? No problem. Christian Davis cleans up a couple of opportunities. That was immediately followed up with a steal by Malvi Leons, finding Davis again, six straight points. And, you know, that's kind of been the Bradley way this season. They've found different ways to win. You get an excellent performance here from Duke Dean. You know, some nights it might be Darius Hanna, who we mentioned at the beginning of the program. Malvi Leons, obviously, is excellent all around, defensively, offensively, a stalwart. Connor Hickman has been a star. Almar Atlasson had a game where he had six three-pointers. It's just kind of been a little bit of everybody this season, and they share the wealth. And, you know, tonight it might be Duke Dean, of course, who's going off. But, you know, next Thursday in the next game in their Valley reopener, it could be somebody else. So just doing a great job of keeping everybody involved.
And Dean really just being asked to do a ton without, you know, Connor Hickman, from a ball handling perspective, too. And fantastic tonight. They get it into Shamar Wright.
And a great rebound by Birch.
Braves looking to pick up their fourth home win of the year, 3:15 to go.
They're looking inside.
They have great positioning for Jonovic, and Lamar Wright fouls him. That's his fourth. And Jonovic will shoot two. That's the 10th team foul on the Cougars.
Yeah, it's something that is second nature for him, but excellent job by Mehta staying big there, sealing off his defender, giving his guards on the perimeter a great big target there in the middle of the lane, and catches the ball, tries to turn and shoot, gets fouled, and is going to go to the line here. Opportunity for two from the charity stripe.
Again, the Braves will host Truman State next Thursday for the non-conference finale, as Jonovic now 2 of 3 from the line. 2 points, got a rebound, a block, and an assist as well. It's a 12-point game, which matches the largest lead of the night for the Braves. Thompson will come back for Pickett, who was in for the first time tonight for SIUE.
And now SIUE's really got to start really pushing it, trying to get the tempo going. You got to start scoring in bunches here. You got to do it quick.
Lamar Wright playing with his 4 fouls, nearly loses it, regains, now under 10 on the shot clock. Lamar Wright backing his way in, goes middle, fades, and was too strong. Lamar Wright gets it back, bounces off of Jovic, and gets the bucket and the foul.
That gives Lamar Wright a ton of credit there, sticking with that play. And gets hammered on the shot as well, falling away from the hoop, banks it in. An opportunity for the old-fashioned 3-point play.
Wright with 7 points, all coming here in the second half. There's Dean. Give and go back to Dean.
They got a mismatch underneath as well, they're looking for, instead of skip to Birch.
Skip other side, Davis, quick trigger 3. And Shamar Wright the rebound.
And now Taylor's gonna go to work, try to get into the lane.
Blocked by Jonovic, up ahead for Birch, all alone for the slam.
What a possession there. Mehta knocks it out the backboard and ahead to Birch for the one-hand tomahawk.
What a sequence by the Braves. Trying to put the exclamation point on this one. Step back 3 by Taylor, and Davis another rebound.
Just excellent IQ there from Ahmet Jonovic as well, knowing that Taylor's gonna be trying to drive and gets downhill, comes on the weak side. An excellent block shot, and an even better pass ahead by Bradley, finding Birch streaking ahead, and now he's gonna go back to the free throw line as well here. What a way to kind of cap off a potential victory for the Braves with an excellent 5-second span there.
And we've talked a lot about Duke Dean tonight, and rightfully so, given his output tonight, but really strong statistical performances as well. We've talked about Leon with his 2nd straight double-double. Christian Davis quietly with 12 points, 8 rebounds, and the man at the line tonight, the freshman Demarion Birch, has been very impressive. 8 points, still 8 points after that first miss there. 4 rebounds, 4 assists, 3 of 6 from the floor, and he's played really well off the bench tonight.
He really has provided a lot of really good minutes and a lot of energy as well. You see off the tomahawk slam off the fast break, getting the crowd going as well too. So that's what you gotta love to see from a young man. And unfortunately misses those 2 free throws, leaving the door cracked open potentially here for the Cougars, but they gotta start scoring here. They might need a 3 ball.
Shamar Wright, contested 3 is short. Bounces off the fingertips of Birch, finds Lamar Wright. Steps into a 3 for a minor, no good. Jonovic clears it for the Braves.
Strong rebound.
All over him, yeah. And he'll shoot 2.
Really nice job, and a good round of applause here from the Carver Arena faithful right there for that tough rebound. And now Mehta goes back to the free throw line for his 3rd trip of the night.
So Jonovic back to the stripe as the Braves looking to put the finishing touches on their potential 7th win of the season. And Leons will come back in for Birch. Will pick up the pressure and slow down the SIUE attack. Splitting a pair of defenders is right. He's bumped on his way in. That's on the floor. It doesn't matter because Cougars in the double bonus. And are they put that on Leons? Or who was that foul?
They're going to get Jonovic on that one. The reach in coming over on the help side.
So that would have been Leons' fifth, but nope, Jonovic.
We talked all night. We got to give SIUE a lot of credit coming in. Put up a pretty good effort here for about 35 minutes before Bradley kind of runs away here in the final minutes. But just the progress that this program has made. You know, you talked about 19 wins last year, their best year in Division I basketball. Year one for Coach Peroni was 8 wins. Since then, they've gone 8, 9, 11, 19. You see the progress. You see, you know, these guys here, they're upperclassmen. You know, the Wright brothers have been here all 5 years. You know, Taylor's been excellent. And you see the culture that he's built. And you see these guys playing hard. And an up-and-coming OVC as well, too. So things are moving in the right direction for sure. And it's going to be a team that's going to be a tough out in the OVC this year, no doubt.
There's no question about it. And I think we kind of knew that even going into the season. They certainly played well, even if they fall tonight and drop to 7-6. You look at the landscape of that league, as we mentioned earlier, Morehead State, the preseason favorite. SIUE should be right there with them the rest of the way. It's going to be a fun battle for that. And then, like you said, it'll be a tough out when tournament time rolls around, which still a couple months out.
Yeah, this is one of those games. Yeah, obviously 54 seconds left. It looks like they're going to be a defeat. But there's a lot of positives you can take from this. And playing a quality Bradley team on the road, yeah, the Cougars don't have a true road win yet this season. That's going to come. And games like this are going to help that for sure.
As Wright sticks with it, gets the bucket, they call a timeout.
Coach Brony's not giving up. He's 42 seconds left here. 9-point game. You know, crazier things have definitely happened. Give him a lot of credit.
A three-possession ball game with just under 42 to go. Pickett's going to come back for SIUE as the Braves have already eclipsed their season average. They came in averaging just under 72 points per game, currently at 73. Like I said earlier in the game, SIUE had held 8 of their 12 opponents to under 70. That's gone against the grain tonight as well. As the Braves look to close out and get another home win here right before Christmas time and the holidays. And hope everyone listening at home has a wonderful time celebrating the holidays with their family. I'm looking forward to it, Matt.
Without a doubt, we got a couple of birthday boys here too coming up, right?
We do.
So
Christmas sandwiched in between our birthdays.
That's
right.
That's right. But Bradley fans definitely get an early Christmas present here tonight with their performances from the star guard and Duke Dean and what he's been able to do tonight with those 7 3-pointers, really leading the way. I mean, he's played almost 36 minutes, hardly left the game. Really done a good job of facilitating as well. We're not just talking about the points, and he's got 3 assists to go with the 27 points and just doing a little bit of everything. And the last 10, 15 minutes really haven't been about Duke Dean.
Right.
It's been the supporting cast of Christian Davis coming up with 12 huge points. Darius Hanna, a couple of big dunks. Kate Hartke off the bench knocking down a triple and excellent defense. Defense was really the key to this Bradley performance tonight. And yeah, gonna get a timeout.
So Braves still with plenty. They'll have 2 timeouts remaining after this timeout. SIUE has 1 to go. But Matt, it's no secret the Braves have struggled and have a difficult stretch the last couple of times out while having dropped five straight. But we've said throughout the course of the last several years is this is a program that knows when to not get too high or too low, but you're too hot or too cold. And like you mentioned earlier, Duke Dean was in that hot category.
Yeah, our graphics department had a hot or cold, and Duke Dean was definitely hot tonight. As you were kind of mentioning, you know, just the overall schematic of the Braves. If Duke Dean is knocking down three-pointers at this clip, I mean, 7-12. It's pretty ridiculous. But if he's hot like this, this team pretty much has no boundaries on how high they can go in the Valley with shooting of that quality. You're talking about as a team, you know, Bradley didn't really shoot that good from behind the arc. You're looking at 12 of 31 for a clip of 39%. Usually looking, if you can be around 40, you're happy. So it's certainly not bad. Sure. But when one guy knocks down seven, what a performance by Duke Dean.
Yeah, and the good news is, I mean, they attempted a lot, and they want to shoot more threes than they have at times throughout the year. And they've been really good when they hit seven or more. They were 20-4 last year when they hit seven or more. And this is a team certainly capable of, but that's one of the encouraging things is they expect that over the course of the season, that three-point percentage will right size, mm-hmm. right? And progress to the mean as Davis knocks down a pair. Really good night for Christian Davis as well. He's part of that. He's got two threes tonight, 14 points, 8 rebounds. And with the Braves an opportunity to go to 7-5 as Lamar Wright has that one drop off the mark. The shot clock is turned off. Let's see if SIUE will let this play out. As Dean gets it across, and the Cougars are going to drop back. And it's going to be fitting that Duke Dean ends with the basketball, and the Braves are back in the win column tonight. Matt McClain, 75-64, the final. They improved to 7-5, and with all the, you know, seesaw emotions of the beginning of the season with unconference game left, the one thing that I'll always say, and that's exciting, is that this group and this program always seems to play their best basketball in the last couple of months of the season. And if that's the case again this year, watch out, right?
Oh yeah, without a doubt. In an uber competitive Missouri Valley Conference, one more non-conference game for Bradley, but like you're mentioning, you know, really still trying to find that groove offensively tonight. A lot better defensive definitely took a step forward. There was a lot of passion for the Braves tonight. You could tell they really wanted this win. They needed this victory, snapping that five-game losing streak. And much-needed win for Bradley. Got to give SIUE a lot of credit as well. Played really tough throughout the majority of the game. Just too much Bradley and too much really unselfishness. And great defense led to better offense for the Braves down the stretch.
That's going to wrap it up for Carver Arena, for Matt McClain, and everyone on our production crew always does a wonderful job. I'm Ryan Beto saying so long from Carver Arena. It's the final from Peoria. It's the Bradley Braves 75 and the SIUE Cougars 64. We hope you enjoyed the broadcast. Have a wonderful holiday. We'll see you next time on The Valley on ESPN.